Okay, this is a requested review. This is actually my second time doing this. The first one really came out crummy. So here is the hopefully new and better version. I'll be doing the Transformers plush figures Slumblebee and Softimus Prime. Overall, I'll do them both together at first. They're pretty nice. When I first heard the idea of Transformers plush figures, I was like, no. I click figures, not dolls. But honestly, the whole concept of them transforming kind of grew on me. And when I saw them in stores, I had to get them. You'll notice maybe they don't sit quite right, although Slumblebee's sitting a lot better than he was the first time. I have kept their tags intact, so there's a nice bulky mass that kind of helps ruin how they'd look if they're originally sitting. So here's their look for both of them together. Pretty nice. I guess I will do Slumblebee first. Look at his car form. He is the Volkswagen Beetle. His front and back tags say BB1 on them. To transform them, it's a really hard process. You may need the instructions. I don't know. Oh, you just tore his guts. And you're going to push and push and pull. And then, basically, you have Slumblebee feeling a little deflated. You know, maybe need some hair. And then this humongous wart on his back. Once he's got his robot body out, just shove the car, I won't say parts, but the car portion inside of his back. And then seal it with the Velcro. And you are, let's get that Velcro in, done. I like it. I think it's a pretty nifty idea. The tag, of course, I've kept intact. If you need the instructions, since this procedure is extremely hard, it teaches you, turn inside out. Very hard to find. It's pretty cool, the little guy. Car detail on the back. He has some inside work on his almost in rear, but it's his back. His hands look kind of funny to me because we have these huge plush hands, yet the inside paint makes them look a lot skinnier than they really are. So we have a lot of black and little hands. His head, of course, looks pretty cool. Except these things kind of push him down. Looks like he had a mohawk. So overall, though, I think it's definitely worth $10. So pop him up there so I can get him to stand. Oh, I did it. Softimus Prime, though, when I saw him, I saw the first picture, I really liked it. I think he's pretty cool. Optimus Prime is one of my favorite characters spanning through all of the series. I think I have more figures of him than any of them. His tag says Prime 1 on it, so I can get that. There you go. He's pretty simple, really. It's basically just same as Slumblebee, except with him, you're going to fold down his legs. There's Velcro on two portions, front and back, and then open the Velcro back here. And, of course, like I said, the tag was in place, so mine maybe looked a little off. In cab mode, or not cab, truck mode. And then just pull out Softimus. And then tuck in the vehicle portion. Fasten. And then fasten all the little Velcro bits. And he's done. And also his legs are Velcroed for truck mode. And you can separate them when he's robot mode. Same detail as Slumblebee. Except he has long smokestacks, so kids, don't poke your eye out with those, because you can't really sue Hasbro for it. Same kind of little problem with the head. You have to get the flaps kind of fold them differently to get them to stand on their own. I like his face a lot. The eyes, I know in the video those look like they're glowing, but in the paint scheme it makes it look like they stand a lot more than the head, because they're obviously a lot lighter. He has the same hands thing as Slumblebee, except, it's a lot more darker paint, so it blends together more. And it's pretty cool, and actually, Prime, you can sometimes get him to stand on his own, which I thought was pretty cool. Yeah. Not perfect, but hey, it works. So, if you see these in stores, I've seen, the Target I've been to, there's a Target really close to my house, and Walmart, they've been sold out of these for a while. When I first saw them, there were, I think, two left in stock. And I got them. I think people are liking these a lot more than they originally thought they were. And I think they're definitely worth $10 each. I don't think they're worth the $100 price tag I saw on Amazon a while back. Someone was selling the set for $100. That's ridiculous. But for $10 together, maybe a little steep, but I liked it. You know, it's a pretty nice little thing to add to your collection. So for you who requested this, I hope it was what you wanted. And I thank you for watching. Have a good one.